Hello YouTubers, Kieran Harland here. You're about to watch a performance that was done on Tuesday, the 22nd of March, 2022, approximately 7 p.m. until 8 p.m. This performance was done by Spectrum Theatre Company, located at the Magic Cat Cafe. So for those of you who is watching, I hope you enjoy our performance. It is called The Happiness Project. So please sit down or walk around and watch or listen to our performance of happiness. This project is about just about over an hour long. So if you do want to watch all of it, and you don't have to if you don't want to. Before the project starts, I must inquire you to do three things. Only if you want to. You don't have to if you don't want to. But I'm only going to say this once and once only. So three things. Number one, subscribe to my channel. It should... there's three ways you can subscribe to my channel. You can subscribe below. You could click onto my watermark. Or you can wait to the end of the video to subscribe. It's up to you. I mean, you don't have to if you don't want to, but the option is there. Second, like the video. You don't have, again, you don't have to like this video. You can put a dislike if you want to. Or you don't have to do anything at this point. And third, you can comment. You can give us opinions, you can give us some feedback. Again, you don't have to if you don't want to, but just in case if this project does get set for Made for Kids, unfortunately Made for Kids doesn't allow you to comment. So just in case this does get set for Made for Kids, you will not be able to comment. But hopefully, if I set this for not for kids, then you can comment only if you want to. But I will set the settings on the comments to hold inappropriate comments, because it'd be held for review, and I'll have to review what you've commented. Okie dokie. Just to let you know, if you do subscribe to my channel, only if you do, there should be a bell icon. Again, you can either click and say that you want to be notified for any new videos that I'll be making, or personal notifications. Like, for example, it'd be as little as a few videos coming up. So it depends if you want to be notified or not, but the option is there. I hope you enjoy our project. Again, it is over an hour long, so I hope you enjoy the video. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next vlog. Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? Please, it's time for the final countdown. The show starts in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's rock.
Thank you.
This performance has been rated U for Universal. This performance contains flashing images which may affect viewers with photosensitive epilepsy. Thank you for coming and welcome to our evening of happiness. My name is Kieran and we are Spectrum. Tonight we explore happiness through poetry, spoken word, storytelling, our real lives
and our imagination. We'll be having a couple of breaks throughout the evening, so please enjoy a drink or two at the bar. But before I start, please make sure you turn off your phones or put them on silent. Thank you very much. So, let's ask the big questions. What is happiness? First up, we have Kevin.
Going out and about, cups of tea, and nice cold pint, discourse, classic soap opera, memories of childhood, dancing to top of pops, being little, having a tea with the family, sitting down and watching TV together.
Happiness is my cats, they make me laugh. I love them, my MacBook, watching YouTube, staying in touch with people, music, it gets me motivated. Halloween, doing makeup and dressing up. Christmas, putting up decorations, opening presents, spending time with family, the beach, collecting seashells.
Happiness is the time song by Bad Drawn Boy. Playing football magic games, walk in the sun, banana milkshake, chili and rice.
Yeah. I see trees of green, red roses too, I see them blue.
Happiness is coming to Spectrum. Bowling, crazy golf, walking along the beach, friends and family, being myself, warm weather, and dressing up for fun.
Happiness is intangible. It's a thought or a feeling. It can take many forms, like being alone with your memories or thoughts of home. You can't sell happiness. It hasn't got a price, although it's very precious, which I think is nice. You cannot buy it either, though many people tried, because it's free, whenever you need it, because it's deep inside. Happiness can be fleeting or last your whole life through. It's vital that we share it, then they'll be happy too.
Caramel chocolate, 6 foot 10 inches. Whilst listening to the soothing sounds of Amber Sea. Whilst listening to the Jellykin songs. Jelly-tastic and cuddling to my Hello Kitty toy. Whilst pretending to be a bubblegum in the light beloved sky. In that place I never feel shy. I smile and I stick my tongue out.
Tonight, so I'm going to slow it down for you.
Okay.
Okay.
Please do.
Happiness is shining ever. Singing family, fishing in five, get in. Backbones, musicals, singing.
Yeah! Thank you, everyone. Now, sometimes feeling happy is about being in a certain place, a location. Where everything feels right. Welcome to our happy places.
I love Beamish. Being there makes me happy. At Christmas time, we have reindeer on field and decorations, and everyone is full of Christmas joy. There are lots of old trams there. They have old-fashioned wooden seats and they are open air. Sometimes get sitting there. There is an old-fashioned sweet shop there. There are people making traditional sweets right there in front of you. They taste delicious. I always get a whole bag of them. A mixture of everything. I save them until I get home. They are very moorish. There is also a steam locomotive. I love riding it. But you get... and it struggles to get up the bank. I love beaver shoes.
The happiest place in the castle is the fruit and veg shop on Chittenden Road. They have boxes of fruit and veg outside. There's mottos, cabbages, peppers, a rainbow of colours. Inside they sell some roses. When I'm inside I feel happy. Sometimes I buy two smoses. They pop them in a brown paper bag. When I'm walking home the smell just sells. When I get home I eat one, give one to Mel. The food and veg shop, I'm feeling really makes me happy.
I'm in South Shields Town Centre. I can see old buildings, fast food restaurants, birds, seagulls and people walking their dogs. Some people sit on benches, there are crowds, but it's not too busy. I hear seagulls flying all over the place. I hear voices from people in the town centre. In the distance, I can hear dogs barking. I smell food drifting through the air. It's a McDonald's. I smell chips. I can also smell perfume and the fresh sea air. It's a sunny day. I feel happy because I'm in South Shields. It makes me happy because it brings back memories from when I was a child. I went shopping there with my grandma and granddad. My granddad bought himself a budgie from there. Great days, great memories.
Jesmond Dean is a bit like a nature reserve, with lots of trees, benches, and a fair few grey squirrels. There's also a lake, a small zoo, and a partly demolished house. When I'm in Jesmond Dean, I feel like I can unwind and relax. I feel like I can take a breath. I don't have to worry or stress like I am in the city. Jesmond Dean is my happy place.
The big wheel, Monkey Connor, the sound effects of music. Wheel, you want to go faster? The smell of donuts, burgers and chips, fried onions, the atmosphere. The band of music! People having fun, and when I'm there, I'm happy, and hopefully I'll get there soon.
Silence. the opposite of noise. It's peacefulness without disquieting thoughts. It's writing my poetry and stories to share, which is why I love the silence, because it allows my imagination to take flight. I love painting pictures using words and thoughts. My go-to place for solitude is the sea. It's soothing when the waves are smooth and glass-like. Even when it's angry, it's still mesmerizing, reflecting as it does the whole spectrum of emotions and light. My autism makes me happy because it's a special gift, like words and emotions. It's a unique part of who I am, although it's not entirely who I am. Almost everything I have achieved is thanks to my autism, and I wouldn't want to be without it. The ability to love and accept love. Without it, we are nothing. It makes life worth living, and it makes me very happy.
Mesdames et messieurs, bienvenue à Paris. Il est 19h45, heure locale. J'espère que vous avez été...
My happy place is France. The landscape is Isle of Sheep, with deep flood valleys and high mountains. They have two sea cheese, my favourite is Brie. I like the shops, they are very, very big, and people talk with a lovely accent.
American candy sweet store with Jekyll and Hyde. It smells enticing and also decrepit, just like my new friend Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. It's loving, cold and warm and has sweets that are big size, with sweet and sour flavours of candy, all around smells of stale lollipops. Well, I'm here, I'm happy.
Thank you, Sarah. Well, it's time to take a short break. The bar is open and we'll be back in around 10 minutes for more happiness.
Welcome back, everyone. Time to return all things happy.
Yay!
So sorry, ladies and gentlemen. We're trying to do a show here. What seems to be the problem?
Tim 501 special. A big plate of happiness, but we can't find the recipe. Has anyone got the recipe?
Who's got the recipe? Who's got the recipe? Who's got it? Who's got it?
Here, found it!
Hello?
Take a big tablespoon of good music.
Yeah.
Stir it till you have to dance. Take a big slice of one of your old friends and have a sprint or good cat. Bake for 20 minutes. Finish up by having a word of yourself. Everything is going to be all right. Keep up and think positive.
Yeah. Has anyone else got the recipe?
Right. I found my original recipe for happiness. Take enough sugar on Quality Street, mix in a dollop of all adverts, then take 21 tablespoons of Halloween, mix it all together, pour into cake tins, pop in the oven on a medium heat and bake for 20 minutes, finally, you shall enjoy your happiness.
Yeah. Yay.
Anyone else?
My recipe for happiness. Take a generous helping of a badly drawn boy. Add a sprinkle of fertilizer games. A generous serving walking in the sunshine. Mix it together with banana milkshake. Finish off with a big dollop of chili and rice.
Yeah.
Well, anymore.
Right, everyone, I've got my recipe for happiness. Take 60 minutes of exercise.
Ooh.
And slowly blend it with some meditation music. Take a large bag of going to see a concert, then cook slowly with a portion of a good Netflix documentary. Finally, finish off with an extra big serving of falling your best friends.
My recipe for happiness. Take a bucket full of love, add a cup of smiles, then take two large jugs of peace, a smidgen of hope, and whisk until smooth. Pour mixture into the world and enjoy.
Ah. Oh,
I'm getting hungry now. I think I've got mine somewhere. Oh, there it is. You may need to brace yourself. My recipe for happiness. Take a big generous slice of music. Hit play and stir into your dance. Take a big chunk full of walkies with hooch. And add a sprinkle of relaxation on the beach or in a nature reserve. Put it in the oven. Guess what? Make it hot. And set a timer for 10 minutes. And voila, mamma mia! You turned that pan upside down! Hip-hip. Well, thanks to our chefs for those wonderful recipes. Now, talking of recipes and looking around these beautiful surroundings, it makes me think about dinner. And what if you had dinner with anyone? And I mean literally anyone. Well, let me start by telling you about the evening I had dinner with the one and only Aslan the Lion. Down boy. I planned a surprise dinner party for the King of Narnia. I wore a black suit with a red shirt and a Star Trek tie. I walked Aslan out of the wardrobe and I walked into the Jubilee. When we got there, I ordered a beef lasagna with cheese. And Aslan orders a vegetarian spaghetti bolognese because if he ate something with meat, he'll become a real wild cat. He asks me, "Are you enjoying yourself tonight?" And I said, "Yes." "Are you enjoying yourself tonight?" He said, "Yes." Then I said, "Well, it's not over yet." So the lights came on and everyone gathered around the table and everyone said, "Surprise!" And Aslan roars with excitement. And we all sang happy birthday to him while a big birthday cake came along with candles around it. Aslan manages to blow out one of the candles, but then he roars the rest of them out. To finish the night, I had a glass of Dr. Pepper, and Aslan, well, he had a bowl of milk. We then walked back home, and I walked him just outside the wardrobe door, and I stroked his mane, but I didn't want to let him go. But I let him go back to Narnia, and the wardrobe door closes itself.
The night I had dinner with Jamie Redknapp, I wore black trousers and a Liverpool t-shirt. We met at Taco Bell, I got the bus there. When I arrived, I said hi, Jamie said hi back. Jamie was wearing a white shirt and trousers. I ordered the cheese taco and a glass of black currant juice. Jamie ordered chicken tacos and red wine. We talked about football. At the end of the meal, I got on the bus. I went home. I felt very happy.
Cruella de Vil, Cruella de Vil.
Oh,
if she doesn't stand, they'll rebuild they will.
Oh,
to save her is to take the sudden chill.
About my night with Cruella de Vil. I wore a beautiful red velvet dress with my hair down in cream. She wore her traditional black and white suit with an animal print jacket. Her hair was half black and half white. We met at my favourite Greek restaurant on the island of Rhodes. We both travelled there on private jet. When we arrived, I said to Cruella, let me introduce you to Stavros. He makes the best mezzes in the whole of Greece. Cruella replied, well, I don't like the look of the place. That Stavros looks a bit scruffy for my liking. I ordered a large mezze for both of us and a large bottle of ouzo with a jug of lemonade on the side. Cruella was very disappointed in the food. She said it wasn't cooked enough and felt ill. I went back to the hotel, but Cruella spent the night being sick. I felt very happy that I got my own way on back on her for trying to steal my Dalmatian puppy. Yeah.
Let me tell you about that time I had dinner with Madonna. What a wonderful night it was. We were in London. I wore a very elegant red dress with three inch high heels, because let's face it, you can't walk in anything higher than that. Madonna wore a very posh black dress with white boots. We met at a popular restaurant that's famous for their pizzas and amazing Italian food. I arrived in a glamorous diamante limousine because he hates Madonna and she likes her glamour. When I got to the restaurant, I said, Madonna, I love your songs and you look incredible with your posh looks. Madonna said, thank you, you look incredible too. We looked at the menus and I ordered a spaghetti bolognese with a garlic bread and a barbecue dip to share with me and a glass of white wine. The food was utterly delicious. My martini was heavenly, nice and sweet. When we got back to my house, we watched some food concerts. We had a glass of martini, popcorn, chocolate and crisps to snack on. We then sung some karaoke. I sang Hungover, Madonna sang Vogue. I felt blessed and really fantastic to share this time with Madonna. My evening with Boudica. I'm sitting here, the firelight is dancing on my face, when suddenly the queen is there, my heart begins to race. Are you a spy? She asks as we are face to face. Of course not, would I risk my neck if that were the case? She deigns to sit, and I can see there's something on her mind. It's almost like she's here with me, but the future's close behind. Across the void, we see the enemy campfires burning bright and hear the sounds of horses whinnying with fright. Are you afraid? I ask, and she just laughs, a hollow sound. Not really, she responds, because we fight for hallowed ground. The Romans think this land is theirs, but just you wait and see. Before the next full moon, we will have gained the victory. Well, it's been great to chat with you. But now it's time to go. Although you dream of victory, there's something you should know. Although the battle you will lose, it's still your side that I would choose. You fought for freedom, took a stand, because you loved this precious land.
Yeah.
my special dinner with my Nana Kath. I wore a white shirt and smart black trousers, black shoes and a smart tartan tie. Nicely shaven and with a brand new haircut. And also I had some cheap aftershave on. My Nana Kath was wearing a beautiful green dress. We went to a 5-star weekend in London. We stayed at the Ritz Hotel. We travelled there by the train. First class. It was very, very fancy. We had a full English breakfast with the works. When we arrived, I said to my Nana Kath, Nana, I am taking you to the Ritz for your dinner tonight. Nana smiled. Oh, that's lovely. I ordered a 3 courses. Soup for starters. 4 stars for all the twins. And a treat of sponge custard for dessert for after. I had a pint of beer. I finished with a cup of tea. Nana had a smaller portion of the roast dinner. And a 7-Up and a cup of tea. When we finished dinner, we went to see a show. Bette Midler and Barry Manilow. After the show, we were returned back to the hotel. We both had a cup of tea at the bar. Then we went back to our rooms for a good night's sleep. I felt absolutely exhausted, but very happy. It was a very successful day, but there's more to come. Nana isn't with me anymore, but she'll be always in my heart. And and she's up there looking over me and she said, behave yourself, to hear me.
Thank you, Kevin, and thank you everyone for sharing your wonderful stories. It's time to take another break. And when we return, it will be our final piece of the show. Welcome back to our final part of our evening. Next up, some happy memories, some hopes, and dreams about the future.
I'm sitting in the room with my family, my mom, and my brother. Everyone's having fun. We're watching Celebrity MasterChef on TV. I hear birds outside the window. I smell onions, cooking. I'm struggling with black cat. I feel happy.
Thank you. And I'm going to tell you about my perfect day. I wake up on a Friday morning with the alarm ringing. I press the button to stop the alarm, and I get up, and it's a pretty blue sky. So, I put on the radio, and funny, Mr. Blue Sky comes on. Out the window, I see lots of buildings. Good old Big Apple. I even have a shower and sing Mr. Blue Sky. And as I was getting clean, I get a phone call from Miss Piggy. She asked me, Kimmy, what are you doing on this beautiful day? And I said, I'm not doing much. I'm walking around the city making more music. So she said, okay, Gary, I'm missing you. And I said I was missing her. So we blow kisses. And ended the call. I finished the shower and went downstairs. And I had some Fruit Loops. Then after breakfast, I took my favorite instrument, the banjo. And I went outside and started strumming it. And started singing my original song, Rainbow Connection. Then I somehow got a phone call, but I haven't got any pockets! So a young man asked me,
are you the Kermit the Frog?
Yes!
Well, it's for you.
Hello, I'm Kermit the Frog. And then I listened to the conversation for about 10 minutes. Then the voice said, they won't be at the Magic Hat in Newcastle upon Tyne. I was so chuffed. I haven't been to Newcastle before. So, I got into the limo to the airport, flew from USA to UK. It felt very strange to return to London, but I got the first class LNER train to Newcastle. It took 3.5 hours. During that time, I messaged Miss Piggy about me going to Newcastle. She texted me saying, stay safe, because the Georgies haven't seen a talking frog before. I text back saying, I will be fine, and I think it's pronounced Geordies. I'm missing you. I arrived in Newcastle and had some lunch at a place called TGI Fridays, which is a restaurant filled with American food. And I have the famous cheeseburger with fries, and a drink of martini. I leave TGI Fridays and use Google Maps to find the Magic Hat, and discovered it's near the Lane Art Gallery. I met up with the Mad Hatter. He seemed to have owned the place. He welcomes me in, and he warns me they're all a bit mad. So the audience starts to come in, and there's about 60 people. I started to get nervous, and I haven't been nervous since me and Jim Henson started the Muppet Show. However, that wasn't the first show. The first show was called the Jim Henson and the Kermit the Sock Puppet Show. Oh, the memories. The lights start to dim, the spotlight shines on me, and I start introducing myself to everyone and talk about what I did today before coming to Newcastle. To finish off, I sing two songs. My original, Rainbow Connection, and The Greatest Showman's This Is Me. Everyone applauded and I was so happy. I then get a phone call from Miss Piggy and Frank Oz asking how my day was. And I said, just listen to that Geordie crowd. Then, Frank. He did his Yoda impression, going,
Jim Henson, front of you, he will be.
And Miss Piggy replied that she agreed. And I said, thanks, guys. And Miss Piggy asked me, saying, Kirby, when are you coming home? And I said, I'll be home as soon as possible. I signed everyone's autograph and got some selfies. I even had a nice drawing of me from one of the kids. And I got into a taxi to the quayside and did one more thing. I took a selfie of me with the time bridge in the background. And I sent it to the Muppets' social media. I got back to the taxi, flew back to good old America, and got a limo to my house. When I got in, switched on the lights, and every one of my friends, including Frank Oz, from the Muppet Show, gave me a surprise congratulations party. I was so happy, but tired at the same time. So, I let everyone enjoy themselves, and there was a banner saying, Kermit is all reet. A jolly term. I went upstairs and had one more surprise. Miss Piggy was in my bed. Don't worry, I'll keep it clean!
Bella!
Kermit, come to bed. We'll make you nice and cozy. So, we kissed, and I imagined a rainbow with Jim's face smiling on me. I closed my eyes and fell asleep. And that suddenly, ladies and gentlemen, was my perfect day. Thank you and good night.
Share with you one of the happiest memories I had. Many years ago, when I was at school, I remember going to the theatre to see a pantomime. Everyone was so excited. You can see all the sheets spread out in front of you in the huge red curtains, and all the stage lights changing colours. The orchestra were practicing their instruments, and you can feel the happiness and excitement all around here. The pantomime was wonderful. At one point, somebody said something funny, nothing, and nothing, so much, and I just couldn't stop. That was 24 years ago. I can still remember that feeling of nothing and nothing. And not being able to stop. Even today, if I think about it, it still makes me smile. I think it's important to always have happy memories.
My perfect day. I got up early and went to the beach to meet friends. It was a beautiful day and so nice to be out in the sunshine. I got a lovely tan and took some photos of the beach and the way the sunshine reflected off the sea with bright, beautiful bright beams. I had fish and chips with a can of Sprite. Afterwards, I got strawberry ice cream with a flake. It was delicious. It was therapeutic to dip my toes in the water and to feel the sand on my body. It felt good to be with friends after the year we've all had. Later that day, we returned to the hotel for a spa night. We really pampered ourselves with a posh meal and prosecco. I had a juicy burger and chips with onion rings and sauces to dip. It was a really perfect day and night, relaxing and so very peaceful. Simply perfect.
My perfect day begins alone. It's a beautiful day, punctuated with nothing but silence. I find myself in an old Italian villa, perhaps once owned by a Roman senator or philosopher such as Plato. There's a library there, and I choose one of the books. It's called The Last Days of Socrates. It's written by Plato. There's a balcony which is bathed in sunlight, ideal for reading. So I grab a nearby chair, and after much fidgeting, I finally settle down to read. Turns out, this book is ideal if you suffer from insomnia, because two pages in, I doze off. In my dream, I am standing in the forum with a woman. I ask her what her name is. Apparently, it's Olivia. The noise and smells are overwhelming. So much for silence. There are people and animals everywhere, and I do mean everywhere. I begin to feel anxious and start to cry. And Olivia throws me a withering look and says, "Stop snivelling, girl, and go buy some of the best Falernian wine and black olives." Well, of all the cheek. Who does she think she is? Oh well, anything to keep the peace. And after walking a few stores along, I find the wine and olive sellers. And after much haggling, I manage to strike a good bargain, which should please the old sourpuss. I'm just on my way back to find her when the book falls off my lap. This in turn wakes me up, and I'm rather relieved to be back in 2022 instead of AD 22. I retrace my steps to the library, return the book to its shelf. This then is my idea of a perfect day.
Care about, the things we love, and the things that makes us happy.
I like to smell aftershave.
Smell chocolate can make you happy.
A good peaches, it has a different kind of smell, but it's quite relaxing as well.
Crab onions, caramels, lots of pizzas.
Perky.
Curry.
I'm full of smooth and fatty.
Smell of beef dinner.
Peace out, chocolate. I like the smell of fresh air, candy floss.
Nature, when you're outside, it's the one just put the grass.
The smell of flowers makes me happy.
Curry! Tips!
Awesome. The smell of turkey can make you happy. Schoenhofer Thief Fairgrounds.
Piano, drums.
Sounds of music.
I like the sound of the rustling leaves where you like walk on leaves.
Music. Training their dreams.
The mood of your queen made me happy.
I just want to make me happy.
What do you count?
Play it open with a bottle of Prosecco.
Bird singing.
Michael playing game makes me happy.
Who's he?
Says I'm looking for.
I think that the synopsis sounds a piece of quiet in my
brain. I love Catherine Jenkins' voice.
Listening to Japanese music makes me happy too.
A film sound like it's that ground, like it. People that are doors.
I guess music.
I love the taste of chocolate.
The taste of kebabs.
I like lemon cookies.
Marshmallows dipped in chocolate.
I would just like coffee, baby.
With the cake.
Pizza, chips.
Beer.
Cheeseburgers.
What on the top?
And the cake of chocolate.
Chocolate crisps.
Curry soup noodles.
Oh, bananas.
And two burgers.
Oh, pizza.
Strawberry garlic.
I love
the taste, like a pizza.
Lasagna, because my mom makes the best lasagna.
I love fish and
chips. Chocolate.
The taste of eating chocolate makes me happy.
Pasta and beer, but none at the same time.
I am such a good actress, happy.
I'll play the drum, make me happy.
Karate makes me happy.
Cooking make me happy.
A wonderful boy matches make me happy.
I like swimming. I like cooking.
No, I'm checking that makes me happy as a twist and dogs.
I like music.
And it would be good video. Music, I'm a
football.
Watching the performances and acting in the performance.
I'm gonna pick him and go, put me on the door.
Want to watch out to make me happy?
Try to do my own film and my own editing and my own my little projects.
Fancy, I'm walking.
Jamie Nakin, in your time.
Drama!
I love acting.
Foreman.
I'm a nice bug.
Acting.
Swimming.
Acting. Volkswagen.
I love to do CrossFit.
I love to watch anime and play my guitar, it makes me happy.
Taking my dog to talk with my mum.
Play on PlayStation.
Freddie Mercury made me happy.
Nadine makes me happy.
I like Miley Cyrus.
Tony Adams.
And...
The Majesty of Me.
Yeah. Elvis. Anyway, that's one of them.
They make me very happy.
With friends and family.
And mum and dad make me happy.
I like my family and my support staff. And my friends.
My mom and dad. Connie make me happy, Nia make me happy.
and obviously my dog.
I'm open because we're always laughing.
Leslie.
Friends.
Brother.
No, darling. Can you say again, brother?
I think you need Adam.
Well, my boyfriend Ryan makes us happy.
Being around all my friends that makes me happy.
I love to my girlfriend, Kevin.
No, come on in, I don't know you lot. Thanks for having me.
That's all, folks. Thank you so much for being such a wonderful audience. And thank you for the magic hat, for your amazing venue. You've been a pleasure to work with. Good night from all of us at Spectrum. Have a safe journey home.
Live long and prosper.